Dear students, finally we have arrived to the actual steps of surgery. I think that is the most interesting and students get most inspired by the actual steps of the cataract surgery. But due importance to be given to all the prior portions of cataract which we have completed, and more importance to be given for preoperative preparation and the block techniques. We cannot skip them also. They are equally important. Now we go to the interesting chapter on the actual steps of cataract surgery. So once having blocked the eye, then we will have to instill 5% povidone iodine. 5% povidone iodine is like, because the normal povidone iodine is used to paint the skin. Similarly, 5% povidone iodine as an eye drop should be applied into the conjunctiva, so that the conjunctiva and cornea, the ocular surface is cleaned. And we do painting of the region, painting, and then draping. We are draping the eye region with a drape. So we have to apply 5% povidone iodine, then do painting and draping. Once having done painting and draping, we use a speculum, and this speculum is used to retract the lids. This is called a wire speculum. It is used to retract the lids. Once you have retracted the lids, then you use a instrument called dastur to hold the superior rectus and take a brittle suture in the superior rectus. This is called a brittle suture because it is a suture which is not tied or knotted. It is just kept for holding on to the superior rectus to control the globe. That is why it is called the brittle suture. Something like how a jockey controls a horse when he is riding a horse. Very much like that, analogous to that is this brittle suture of the superior rectus. Then we do a conjunctival peritomy. We take a scissors and cut the conjunctiva at the limbus so that we reflect the conjunctiva and expose the limbus. That is the idea. We have to expose the limbus where we are going to make the actual incision. So in this reflecting step, if there is a wound coming out of this, Then we will have to cauterize this area. So this conjunctival reflected area will be cauterized and made without any oozing of blood. And then we use a knife and make a scleral section. The scleral section will be like a frown. It is called a frown section. Can you see a frown section? A straight section can also be made. It can be a straight section, or it can be a frown section. A frown section is considered to be better. Structural wise, it is considered to be better. Once that section is made, then we use a crescent knife. This is a crescent knife. Can you see the tip of the knife? The tip of the knife is like a crescent, no? So it is called a tunnel blade or a crescent blade. This crescent blade is used to tunnel this incision. Once you tunnel this incision, then you have created the sutureless wound which can be entered. That is the tunnel wound. Okay, tunnel wound. Once the tunnel wound is created, then we can enter. So this is the tunnel. If you see, this is the tunnel which is created, and we have entered now. Then we have to make a side port also. This is called a side port knife. And we have to make a side port incision, because in the cataract surgery, a lot of steps are involved. Certain steps should be done through the main port. Like you see here, once a side port is made, what I'm doing, I'm injecting an air bubble and I'm injecting trypan blue. Can you see the blue dye here? This is the trypan blue dye which I'm injecting. Once I inject the trypan blue dye, I will get the stain of the capsule better. Once I have got the capsule stained, I am using a sharp 26 gauge needle and doing a capsulotomy. This capsulotomy can be done as a CCC. This is called a CCC, triple C, or it can be done as a can opener. But this can opener is not a good technique. This triple C is a good technique. If you consider which is a good technique, triple C is a good technique. It is called continuous curvilinear capsular excess. It is a very good technique to open up the anterior capsule and expose the contents of the lens. Then what you do, you will use an entry keratome. This is called an entry keratome. Okay, Previously, we were using a crescent blade, if you remember. Now, this entry keratome is used to enter the tunnel which we have created and extend it to that rough 6 millimeter size. Once that is done, then we take a cannula inside and inject saline under the anterior capsule. Under the anterior capsule, we inject saline. Because we inject saline under the anterior capsule, the whole nucleus becomes a bit loosened and trying to becoming free of the capsular attachment. This is called hydrodissection. This step is called hydrodissection. Once hydrodissection is done, then the nucleus can be rotated and can be prolapsed into the anterior chamber. Now the nucleus is separated and it is free. Now you can rotate it and prolapse it to the anterior chamber. Once having prolapsed the nucleus to the anterior chamber, then we use a special instrument called a Vectis. We use an instrument called a Vectis. This is a Vectis. There are two Vectis, an irrigating Vectis and a rigid Vectis. This Vectis instrument is used to engage the nucleus and express it out of the main wound. The nucleus is expressed out of the main wound. Now, once the nucleus is expressed out of the main wound, all you have is the loose cortical matter. For that, we use an instrument called Simcoe cannula. And the Simcoe cannula is used to wash the cortical matter present in the capsular bag. This kind of steps now create a perfect capsular bag. And you see, all the nucleus, cortex are removed. So there is a perfect capsular bag. Into this perfect capsular bag, you again inject the viscoelastic and make space and proceed to implant the intraocular lens. This is the intraocular lens. This is the haptic of the intraocular lens. This is the optic of the intraocular lens. This is the dialing hole. Can you see the dialing hole? And this lens is slowly implanted into the capsular bag. Once it is implanted into the capsular bag, we can use a dialer and adjust it in position and keep it in position. And then the viscoelastics can be removed and this wound can be just hydrated and closed. It doesn't need any suturing because it is a sutureless wound. And with this, we come to the end of the SICS steps. So SICS steps are definitive steps which start from painting and draping to final hydration and closing of the wound. These steps you have to go again and again, 2 or 3 times into these steps and see them and remember them in order with the instrument which is mostly commonly used for that particular step. That also you will have to remember for each step. Okay, thank you.